Shiloh.
Like this, the Mises is a, if you want to know the real story, the story is like this, that there's, on Pesach, which he said is the Leidas, right? That's already the birth, and Tezlov is the conception. So on Pesach we drink four cups of wine, right? Why do you drink four cups of wine? It says it's something about lakachti before the shyness, general idea. Drink four cups of wine. But it's very interesting. How do we start? What's the movement? You asked why mixing, why the movement? How do we start? If there are four realms that you want to reach, you want to go from the world of Asiya, which is the world. Not go from, but you want to. The world, there's the world of Asiya, which is the physical, the tangible, the immediate world. And then there's the world of Yetzira, which is an inner world, a more emotional, connected place. And then there's the world of Bria, which is a mental, a mindful place. And then there's the world of Atzilus, which is the world of unity. Which these four realms also correspond to the spheres, which is Atzilus' Chachma. Wisdom, higher intuition, like Ruach HaKodesh. And then Bria, which is the mental state, is the world of Bina. And Yetzira is connected to the emotions, the six emotions. And Asiya is connected to Malchus. So the Arizal writes that on Pesach, how do we start Pesach? So normal movement, normal growth, you would think, start from the lower. And you progress, you move forward, you start from Asiya, and you climb a little higher and a little deeper, and you move into the world of Yetzira. It becomes a little more subtle, more quiet, and more deep, and you go into the world of Bria. And then you reach the world of Atzilus. This is the normal progression of a person, and this is the way the Baal Shem Tov talks about a person when they daven. Besides that, the four movements, the four passages of davening, correspond to these four worlds. When you first we say the karbanos corresponds, the offerings correspond to the world of Asiya. Then we say the ashrays and alukas corresponds to the world of Yetzirah, emotional. That Shema Yisrael means to understand, to listen, to understand. The Achdus Hashem, the oneness of Hashem, which is the world of Bria. And finally get to Shmona Esrei, the Amidah, which is a state of unity and stillness where you reach the level of Atzilus. Right? So you're moving, you're progressing up. But the Arizal writes that on Pesach, it's a reverse order. On Pesach, the order begins from Atzilus. The first cup is Chachma Atzilus. The first cup, you start from the top. And then you go to Bina, to Yetzira, then you go to Bria, then to Yetzira, then to Asiya. Which is the progression, the progression is not from the bottom up, but from the top down. Which means, what does this internally mean? It means that on Pesach, there's a gift of freedom, which is called Moichel de Godless. Godless, Godless Shady. Moichel de Godless means you're in a state of constriction, you're in a state of limitation, you're in a state of unclarity, you're in a state of confusion. And sometimes Hashem gifts you. It's a gift, it's a matana. Hashem gives you a service, a type of awakening that comes from above, that all of a sudden your life makes total sense. You don't understand why your life makes sense, and you can't translate why your life makes sense, but all of a sudden there's a type of clarity, of amuna, of faith, and clarity, and a chavas amoicha, and openness, expansion of the mind, but all of a sudden it just, it's like the sea is parted, and it becomes clear. How long does it last? A few minutes. Maybe an hour. Maybe a day. But it doesn't last too long. Why? Because it's something that was gifted to you. There's no talk of Pesach. We're gifted freedom. And since Pesach we're gifted freedom, therefore the movement starts from above to below. You sit down by the Seder. By the way, everyone has this experience. Even if not people on a very high level madrega, any person experiences, just like people have Monday morning blues, I think it's a real thing, people have post-seder trauma. Yeah, exactly, PSD. What's the post-seder trauma? Post-seder trauma is you waited for the seder the whole a month, at least a month. It's going to be, the seder is going to be, it's going to be unbelievable. You sit down, you make kiddush, and it's, you're flying. You're not flying, but something's happening. And the next morning you wake up and you're like, what just happened? I got a little drunk, ate too much matzah, I don't feel good. And you feel like a descent. So the Arizal says this is something that's real. And this is the katnas that comes after the godless. This is the constriction that comes after the bigness. Because a Pesach, everything was given to you as a gift. You were gifted. It was beyond your tools, beyond your kelim. And therefore, you weren't able to assimilate them, you weren't able to integrate them, and you're left with your small self. This is the movement of Pesach. Today, we don't have that. We don't have that Ayin of Pesach. We're still in the middle of the winter. It's still the winter months. And therefore, you have to slowly build the vessels, the kelim, in order to receive some type of expansiveness. We have to progress slowly. To start at the bottom and recognize where we are, who we are, right this present moment, Bashar Hashem, who are we right now? And embrace that person and slowly, slowly break open the clip of that person. You follow? So you're starting from the lower, starting from Asiya, and you're slowly moving into the worlds. So you start with red wine. Why? Because the red wine represents the fullness, the gvura, the fullness of creation. And then the red starts becoming a little more light, and light, and lighter, until it becomes transparent. And then you're left with pure consciousness, pure vodka. This is the movement. Yeah. We're talking a lot of big things. We should talk small things first. We have to talk about something very important. But first I want to say Chaim. What's that with Chaim? Chaim, I know Chaim is with Chaim. The drink with Chaim. You can't say Chaim. Chaim. They're all. Ellie, what's going to be?